Web accessibility perspectives. Video captions. Video isn't just about pictures, it's also about sound. Without the audio, you'd have to guess what this film is about. Frustrating, isn't it? Not knowing what's going on. That's the situation for everyone who can't hear. Captions make videos accessible, which is also handy for people who want to watch video in loud environments or where you need to be very, very quiet. Colors with good contrast. There's something about great design that allows it to go practically unnoticed. But it doesn't take much to make things confusing and frustrating. Choosing colors with poor contrast makes navigating, reading, and interacting a real pain. Good design means sufficient contrast between foreground and background colors. That's not just text and images, but links, icons, and buttons. If it's important enough to be seen, then it needs to be clear. And this is essential for people with low contrast sensitivity, which becomes more common as we age. With good colors, websites and applications can be easier to use in more situations, like in different lighting conditions. Voice recognition. Imagine if you could only communicate with your family by writing. Sometimes it's just easier to speak. One of the advances of technology is voice recognition, whether it's searching the web,
19th century architecture,
dictating emails,
send email to Jack Hardy,
or controlling your navigation app. Many people with physical disabilities rely on voice recognition to use the computer.
Place order.
But for that to happen, websites and apps need to be properly coded.
Go. Cancel.
Voice recognition can help lots of other people with temporary limitations too, like an injured arm.
Place order.
It can also prevent injuries becoming worse, like RSI, repetitive stress injury, or for people simply preferring voice.
Text to speech.
Some people can see the text on this screen. Fortunately, computers can convert text to speech.
It's technology that many people who are blind have been relying on for years. But it's also important for many people with dyslexia and very useful for people with difficulty reading text, as well as some people who just like to multitask. But for this to work, websites and apps have to be properly coded, which has the added benefit of helping search engines index websites' contents better. Clear layout and design. Poor layout can be very frustrating. And the same applies to the web. Good design involves good layout, and that means a better user experience. This includes clear headings, navigation bars, and consistent styling. Any web user will get frustrated with bad layout and design. Complex layouts also make finding information difficult or impossible for people with visual disabilities. And they are confusing for people with cognitive and learning disabilities who need clarity and consistency of the presentation. Bad design also impacts anyone who isn't particularly confident around computers. Notifications and feedback. All the right gears can be put in motion. The hands can be at the exact place they need to be. But if you don't get the response that you're expecting, you'll end up wondering if there's some sort of problem. It's the same on the web. Without clear notifications and feedback, people are quickly disoriented and confused, especially error messages, which are often complex and confusing. Yet making them understandable is usually quite simple. Making websites and apps predictable and understandable makes them accessible to people with cognitive and learning disabilities, and more usable for everyone, especially for people with lower computer skills. large links, buttons, and controls. Trying to hit a small target requires lots of effort. Many websites and applications try to thread the needle. But on the web, we can make areas for clicking and tapping larger and easier to use, which is handy on mobile devices, especially when we might be moving around at the time, which is critical for people with reduced dexterity.
Customizable text. What's right for you doesn't necessarily work for the next person. Customization isn't always just a question of preference, though. Sometimes it's a necessity. Being able to adjust the text is crucial for people with low vision and dyslexia. Properly coded websites and applications allow the text to be customized. For example, to change its size, spacing, font, and colors without loss of functions or clarity. Understandable content. Instead of saying, to postulate a conceit more irksome than being addressed in sesquipedalian syntax is adamantine, it is better to say, being spoken to in unnecessarily long and complicated language is a pain. Yet many websites lack structuring, using headings, lists, and separation. Or they use overly complex language, jargon, and unexplained acronyms. It makes them difficult and unappealing to use for many people, including non-native speakers, and makes them unusable for people with cognitive and learning disabilities.
Keyboard compatibility. Not being able to use your computer because your mouse doesn't work is frustrating. Many people use only the keyboard to navigate websites, either through preference or circumstance. Whether it's temporarily limited mobility, a permanent physical disability, or simply a broken mouse, the result is the same. Websites and apps need to be operable by keyboard. Web accessibility, essential for some, useful for all. Visit w3.org/wai/perspectives.